Hey friends, welcome back to my channel and happy Black History Month. I love it. All right, I get so much life from Black History Month every single year. I've done a ton of Black owned content through last year. I've got my Black owned series here on YouTube. I've done a ton of blog posts. So what I'm gonna do in order to celebrate and help to encourage you guys to remember to shop Black is I'm gonna go ahead and link them below in this video. So it is literally like a plethora of shopping Black links, all the information that you're gonna need just to really make it easier. So all the information is there, but today I wanna focus more, I guess, on me. I'm gonna give you guys a little bit of a life update, let you guys know some things that are going on that you probably maybe didn't really even know about, and also really kind of focus mostly on self-care. Like, I feel like I'm getting ready to tell y'all that you've been self-caring wrong your entire life. And I know I have, especially last year. I've learned the hard way, but I've started implementing new things this year already. It's literally only February, but my life has already changed. So I just feel really led, like I feel it on my heart to share this with you guys because it's a night and day difference. The person who I am this year is not the person who I was this year, and I want to inspire the same thing in you guys as well. So let's just go ahead and get into it. All right, life update. Let me drink a little bit of my green juice. This is actually one of my updates for you guys. If you follow along on my IG stories, you know that I'm a foodie. I love food, and it's not the healthy kind. I just love to eat food that tastes really, really good. And so, yes, I'm not the healthiest eater ever, but I have actually tried to make a commitment this year to do a little bit better. Okay, so instead of actually limiting myself from eating like all the stuff that I absolutely love, that like brings me actual joy, instead of limiting myself, I'm just going to include some more healthier aspects to my diet in a sustainable way. So that is gonna be this green juice. It's like a powder. You mix it in with water and boom, that's it. You don't have to take out a blender. You don't have to blend up a bunch of fruits. It's great, it's quick, it's easy, and I love it. It's by Pericone MD. It's a superfoods supplement, so it's actually really good. It's packed with like kale and all that good stuff, and I swear to you, it actually tastes good. I'm very, very picky when it comes to that stuff. I'm not gonna tell y'all to get a green juice that tastes green. It doesn't taste green. It tastes really good. It's not overly sweet, but it does have like a little bit of sweetness in there, so it like it's actually enjoyable to drink, and I actually look forward to drinking it every single day. If you're like me and you are a foodie, make sure, especially as we're getting on into our 30s. I'm 26, but I'm being a little dramatic. But they say if you can get your like diet and your lifestyle like all together in your 20s, especially your late 20s, then you're like really kind of like ahead of the game. So I'm trying to like fix it up a little bit. And so yes, green juice. 10 out of 10 recommend. This will be linked in the description box below. Anyways, what I really wanted to talk to you guys about was self-care and self-caring the right way. But first, we gotta talk about 2020, because the way I was trying to self-care in 2020 looks completely different to the way I'm doing it this year. So last year was hard for everybody. We all know this. I started off the year moving away from my family, my friends, making this big business move, this big decision, put my big girl panties on, to come here, move to Atlanta, and then poof, boom, the whole world like goes upside down. So like it was difficult to say the absolute least, but my thing, like the way I tried to soothe myself last year, it was a little bit more like instant gratification things, and I just allowed myself to do whatever I want, whatever would make me feel better in the moment, which I think is like 100% and completely totally fine. Like if I could go back, I wouldn't change it, just because I feel like that's what I needed in the moment. And honestly, I was just doing whatever would get me by, what would get me through the next 24 hours without just completely falling apart. So for me, like my self-care looked like laying in bed and watching Netflix and giving myself that rest whenever I needed it. I would also eat like crazy, and I'm talking like not stuff that I would cook, you know, because always when you're cooking, it's always gonna be a little bit healthier than what you could get out on the road most times, right? Depending on what you're cooking, obviously, but most times it's healthier for you to cook at home. I wasn't cooking at all. I basically should be like a shareholder of DoorDash and Uber Eats, because I was just ordering like crazy. So yeah, Netflixing, eating a lot of food, and like those are things that are like soothing in the moment. It's that instant gratification that kind of got me through the next couple of hours. And it was just, I don't know, it was just a cycle. I just kept doing it every day, every day, every day. Another one, big one, retail therapy. I spent a lot of money on clothes. You guys saw I did a couple of hauls last year. That was really fun. But I also did not have the money to be spending like that. And there are things that I didn't even share that I did go ahead and purchase, and I was doing literally anything that was like, oh, this is good, this feels good in the moment, forget it, I'll figure it out, it's fine. And like I said, all well and great when you are kind of in crisis mode, which is kind of what last year felt like. Whew, but boy, have I learned something important, and honestly, it's changing me. It's changing me the way I think, the way I feel, and the way that my mental state, I just, like, it's changing everything. So I need to share this with you. And so what I've learned is, and it's gonna sound simple when I say it, but like actually doing it and putting it into practice and being disciplined with it is like, ugh. So what I learned is engage in more productive self-care. Like, not all self-care, like true self-care, is going to be like an instant gratification. Actually, sometimes the most profound self-care things are things that you actually don't want to do. So for me personally, what that kind of looks like now, for example, is like instead of ordering out on DoorDash and Uber Eats, I am going to Publix, driving my little butt to Publix, double masking, doing whatever I gotta do to make sure I'm safe, but I'm going to the supermarket, I'm purchasing things, and then I'm cooking at home. And that created kind of two things for me. One is like a fun project. You know, I get to research recipes, try them out, and like explore little things. I think that's a really great thing to do in your late 20s anyway. You're still trying to figure out life on your own, and you know, it's just, I don't know, I guess me as a creator, I like doing things with my hands and creating things, so cooking for me sometimes is just like really fun. That creator in me just gets so excited about it. But then too, it's also a lot healthier because I get to control exactly what I'm putting in my food. It's not going to be super grease heavy, it's not going to be overly filled with salt, you know what I mean, because I'm able to control it the way I want to. Another change that I made, I'm not gonna lie to y'all, I'm gonna be real, I'm still trying to implement this change. I fell short on January, but what I'm trying to do is, I love my Netflix, okay, I love it. A lot of times I work with Netflix on, I love it. So I didn't really want to take that away from myself. I don't want to like punish myself, you know what I mean? So instead, I have decided that, okay, you can watch your Netflix, but make sure you're reading one book a month. And that's it. So that would make me feel a little bit better. I'm learning things from these books that I'm reading. And so, like I said, I did fall short of January, but you know, I'm gonna implement it. It's just little changes like that where you necessarily don't want to do it, but in the long run, like, it's gonna be so much better. And it hasn't even been like a long run for me. It's been January and that's it. But my mindset, my emotional well-being, I just feel so much more balanced. I feel alive, I feel happy, and there's still a whole pandemic outside, but I'm able to control what I can control in my little place of peace, you know what I mean? So that's kind of what I'm focusing on, and it's really been working. It has been working, y'all. I'm telling you, like, it's so amazing. Even with the retail therapy, I never used to call it like just shopping online. It was always retail therapy, 100% necessary. I need the newest candles from Forever Mood. I need the newest sunglasses from Desi. No, I had to tell myself, like, okay, really sit back and think about it. What's really gonna happen if you don't purchase the newest thing that pops out? Or what happens if you don't capitalize on that little 20% off sale that they keep emailing you about? Like, what's really gonna happen? And I thought, like, at the end of the day, nothing. I'm gonna be fine. And another thing that has really helped me to stop, like completely stop purchasing these random things online is also to create some really huge financial goals. So right now I am renting a house, but I would love to be able to own my own house here in Atlanta. I do own an apartment in the Cayman Islands that I do rent out, but I would love to own a second property that is just for me, one that I actually live in and I can make my own. So that's like a little goal of mine, and when I sit down and think like, ooh, I'm really itching to shop, I'd be like, okay, but we need to save for the house. And I'm so excited for that kind of thing, that moment where I get the house. Like, it's just, there's nothing more exciting to me. So when I remember that, I'm like, oh yeah, it's fine, worth it, we'll live without it for now, you know what I mean? So I'm kind of taking this year as my, you know, work with what you got year, save what you can year, build your financial wealth year, okay? And I feel like this is something so important to get a grasp on in your 20s. Like, nobody teaches you to do all of these things. You kind of got to figure it out through trial and error. And yeah, last year was a whole bunch of trial and a whole bunch of error for me, but that's why I'm kind of here sharing with you guys, so hopefully you can learn it with me without having to go through all the errors that I went through, because I came out of 2020 with a whole bunch of weight gain that I'm not used to that, okay? I have always been this skinny. That's just the way that my genetics are made. And so to put on all of that weight after all of that eating that I was doing, I wasn't going anywhere, I wasn't moving my body. I was one in two times, I was like, oh, let me work out, but I was never consistent with it either. So I ended up putting on weight, and that was a result of the self-care that I was engaging in last year. So, but with my new self-care, I am already feeling better. I'm less bloated. I'm not bloated at all anymore. I used to eat so much and like such like greasy foods and stuff that I would, after every meal, I would feel uncomfortably bloated. Like that extreme bloating that you just like, oh, you can't do anything. You gotta lay down and you gotta moan a little bit because it's just so uncomfortable. Haven't felt that all year. High five to me, because I'm proud, okay? So yeah, those main things in my self-care routine are really, really different. And not only have I like switched up the way I'm doing self-care, I've also added a couple of new things. So I have like a little morning routine that I do now, and it's nothing complicated. If you follow me on IG, you see it on stories every single day, and that is basically, in the morning, I have a set routine, and that happens every single morning. So every morning I get up, I walk Hershey, and when I come back inside, the first thing that I do is I sit back down in my bed and I do my devotions, and then I read my affirmation of the day. I also have a set of affirmations that are sitting up posted in my office. Those are my affirmations of the entire year, and I will read through those most days as well. But just having that set structure every day to do my devotion, talk to God a little bit, and then have my little affirmation, build myself up a little bit, it always helps me start the day the right way, like seriously. And again, you might wake up in a mood one day and it's like, I don't feel like going back and doing my devotion, I don't feel like doing this, all I want to do is just lay down because I don't feel good. It's so easy to feel overwhelmed by what's happening outside. This pandemic is real, this pandemic is crazy, but you know, you don't need to let that affect you. Just think about what you can control, and what you can control is your mindset and like your little piece, whether it's your house, your apartment, your room, if it's just your room, like you get to control that. And when you're there, engage in that productive type of self-care that's really actually gonna feed you, and not feed you the way I fed myself last year. I have to say, like, I feel like the universe is already responding to me. I'm really huge on like manifesting what you want to achieve in this life, and I really and truly feel like the universe is already responding. Like, there have been, I literally, like, just this past week, I have cried so many tears of joy because of opportunities that just keep popping up in my email inbox. And I'm not saying this to show off, I'm just saying that it works. Like, when you work on your mindset, when you do things that truly like actually feed you, and when you just affirm and manifest exactly what you want to achieve in this life, you can do it. You can do it. Once you can picture it in here, it's yours. You just have to put in the work, and that's literally it. I mean, I still get up some days and I feel like I don't want to do anything, but the difference between last year and this year is that I'm telling myself, you gotta get up, at least do your morning routine, and you gotta do what you can do, and just show up. Just show up for yourself. That's it. Just show up for yourself. Be selfish. Do what you need to do for you in a healthy way, and I promise you, like, it's so good. It's a really, really good feeling. Maybe not in the moment when you're like feeling like it's a chore to do it, but at the end of the day, you're gonna look back after like a week of doing that, you're gonna be able to look back and be like, yo, I'm so proud of you, and look what we achieved. You know, you're just gonna feel so good, so good. And that's just how I've been feeling. it's made all the difference. So I really hope that you guys will take something from this and feel encouraged to kind of take a look at your self-care routines and just switch it in the way that you need to, that is really going to like actually feed you, like feed your soul and put you closer towards actually achieving your goals. I know this is a different style of video than we normally do, but I did promise that I wanted to share a little bit more of me, and I honestly felt so led to do this because of how good I've been feeling. I want y'all to feel good too. From January 1st, I have been saying it is hashtag Thrive 2021, okay? So if you guys are gonna go ahead and do your little self-care things, make sure that you're engaging in productive self-care. Make sure you hashtag Thrive2021 and also tag me so I can see and we can all literally thrive and flourish together. Thank you guys, as always, for being the best curl squad ever. I have so many exciting things coming up this year that I literally cannot wait for us to do all together. I literally feel like we get to do this together. So yeah, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any additional questions or any other self-care tips, please comment them below. Let's have a whole self-care regimen in the comments. All right, let's do this. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will catch you in the next one. Bye.